Here we go, boys. We've got the trouble. Barbarian GR 150 with not even 3200 Paragon. This one, since I've done it off stream, it was without camera, so I decided that I'll do a voiceover after that, narrating it and trying to explain how I did it. So this is the HOTA build. LOD, of course, with a seasonal power of HOTA that every 10th hit does this wave, as you can see here, with that deals actually 10 times the damage of your HOTA. And the strategy for this is quite simple. You want to hit wide open maps, as almost with every build. You want density. You want to kill stuff, get the balance, and you want on one of these maps, be it floor 1 or at least floor 2, ideally it's floor 1, you want a Condi, destroy all the trash with your HOTA, gather all the elites around the Condi, get the elites down, and just maintain the advantage after that with trash, hopefully getting a power pylon at the boss. If not, any other pylon actually will do it. This build almost requires a pylon at the boss, because it works with area damage. It also resets easily your War for the Berserker and Ancients. So here we go. I open Weeping Hollow. And it was with Grotesques and Summoners, not the worst one at all. That's looking quite good, promising. We've got some blues here. So we got so far, as you can see here in the chat, we got 3 blues and 1 yellow, which is bad. Usually you want, if it's the floor with Condi, you want as much as possible yellows. You always hope for yellows. So if the floor is with a Condi, you want yellows. If the floor is without Condi, you want blues. Because blues you can kill actually with HOTA. Yellows you can kill as well, but it takes an eternity. So usually you'll kill yellows that you get at the beginning of the map. And then progressing, you kite them. And slowly they will die. At some point they will die. So here, as you can see, I get this bunch of blues. I've already had the decent progression. And I decided here to stop because the pool is quite decent. We want big pools because this... the damage itself doesn't scale with density directly, as in Blood Nova, as we did with Necro. But it scales indirectly because it procs area damage. So the more density you have, the more area damage will be dealt around. So the mobs will kill, will die much faster. The mobs will kill their neighbors and so on. And their neighbors will kill themselves. That's how area damage works. It procs around the mob you hit. The mob itself doesn't take the area damage, but everything around takes it. And when you have a lot of them around, like, it's a chain reaction. So I'm trying to not burn all the pylon spots here. So we've done half of a map, no pylon yet. And at this point, the pylons will be like, we have several spots here in center, but also all the peripherals have a lot of pylon spots. So usually you want to go on the edge, do some damage, do some progression, and then from time to time you will burn spots one by one in the center. Because ideally you want a Condi spawn in the center, because it's much easier to gather the elites from around the map into the center. It's the minimal distance from, it's like a sun, you know, like with rays. This is the optimal point. Unfortunately, we didn't get one. So here, what I'm doing, you can see that slowly we're killing blues. We have some illusionist as well. And we are trying as hard as possible to maintain our bar, not to fall too much behind. Because if you fall too much behind, then even with a Condi, you probably will not gonna do it. It will not be enough. So you want your bar to be even or almost even. As you can see, we killed a blue there. We will kill another one. And we are maintaining it even or even with a small advantage, then you want the Condi. And here what we see, we went from the, my logic here was that, my strategy was that we went from the down corner of this map, that's the entrance in the map, and then the left corner and the top corner are not exits, so the exit will be on the right corner. It's always a corner, it's like a rhomb, like a diamond. So it's always the corner. So here I on purpose leave this area, as you can see on the minimap here, I leave this area unexplored because here are some pylon spots. And my logic here is because I didn't get the condi in the middle, I want those spots to check them at the end, because even if we get a condi, I want it close to the exit. First of all, because on this map, quite often one of the packs will be spot on the narrow road that leads to the exit or near the exit. So there is a chance there will be a pack. It's not always, but it spawns quite often there. So if the condi is close to the exit, first of all, like you kill the pool of yellows and blues you pull to the condi, and then you'll have some condi remaining. So you are very close to that pack, so you maximize your chances to kill that pack, especially if it's a blue. If it's a blue, it's almost a guaranteed kill. On the other hand, if we don't have it, the pack there, you are still close to exit, so with the remaining condi, you have more time on the next floor to kill some trash, actually. And that way, you maximize your condi value. So here we gathered another pool. You can see that we are killing blues quite easily. And we even killed a yellow here, you can see in the chat. And at this point, we got a condi and we got it completely. This is the last spot here and I wanted to burn it before I go up. And unfortunately, it's found a condi and it's not the best scenario because half of the elites we killed. You can see here, I'm counting the elites. The good way that you can do whenever you get a condi and you want to remember, you don't remember how many elites you have, you just pause the game and you look into the chat. From this point here, from return to town, everything down is this map. So I counted how many elites I encountered and how many do I have to make sure I have everything near the condi. This is very important. So I realized that I had two or three yellows still alive on the map, which we can see here. I can see the hedgehog one, then I can see this one, the blazer, and I decided at this point to take it. And my hope here is, this is by far not the best condi because half of the elites were killed manually. You want actually to get the condi early to kill all the elites, that way you get more time. But I had no choice, so I took the condi. We have still, I think, three yellows here at least, or four. It's three at least, as far as I remember. And then I'm hoping that with this progression that we will get, we will still have a pylon towards the exit. Or if not, it will be like on the next floor. Actually, I'm not hoping to have a pylon, but it's very probable that we will have it before because I left it the area there. So let's see what happens. We killed, it was three yellows. Like two on the map and one from the pylon, of course. We have quite a good advantage. We proc'd as very silly there, just from a laser beam. And then we can see we have a shield. And at this point, since we are quite close to 98, I'm not sure. You can see the pack. That's what I was talking about. You've seen there it was a blue pack. So if that shield was a condi, actually, we would have time to kill the pack. At this point, I decided to leave the shield because I was not sure that we will get another pylon at 98. I had once a condi with 8 elites, 8 minutes advantage, and I never get another pylon, so I failed that one before. And this traumatic experience just made me afraid at this point, and I left it. I decided that I leave that one for the boss, and if we spawn a power on this level, like at 98, that's fine, we will kill the boss here and we will forget about that. Also, it's close to the entrance, so I could run, take the shield and come back and kill the boss here. If we get the power. So here now the target, as you can see, we finally got a very good continuation, a good forest. With good mobs, quite pretty decent mobs. So the plan here is to do 98% and check for a pylon if we don't get a pylon. And if not, we are going back to level 1. Do the rest of 2% there and fight the boss at that level. So here I'm trying to be very careful not to do too much pull, too large of a pulls because it's 95 already. I'm starting to kill really careful because we don't want to spawn the boss here without any pylon. This will basically reduce our chances to zero. You need a pylon with this build, at my Paragon at least, to maximize your chances, because then you get area damage and also you get the pylon benefit. But it's mostly of area damage, especially if you get an Elo pack. So here we are doing 96. I'm trying to make small pulls, 97, and at 98. Here is 98, and I decided that that's it. I'm going down. Did I check for a pylon? I'm not sure I checked down for a pylon. I think I'm just going back. Not sure why. Maybe I could have checked for a power down. But yeah, I just decided to go back. The time, like, we need like 3 minutes plus. So we are quite short on time. And here the problem now is also we have not so many mobs left. But still, in this pool, I've estimated that we had 2%. The problem here, because the pool is very small, there is less area damage, and they will die quite slow, especially as the pool goes thinner and thinner, you can see. So yeah, we stopped here and we start to do our damage. I'm hoping to, like, we need to spawn the boss as soon as possible. I'm taking the Oculus. Boom, boom, boom. And at 99, you can see that it takes, because the pool got thinner, it takes an eternity to get that 1%. I was so nervous here, like, will it be another fail? I spent like 5,000 keys already on this Barbarian, approximately, like, estimated 5,000. It's not like I didn't count, but it's a lot, like 3 weeks of pushing. And you can see it's not like I wasted like almost 1 minute, I think, here just to spawn that. Like, it's 40 seconds at least. We got Orlash, which is not the worst boss. That's a good, okay-ish boss, I would say. It's not a bad boss. That's all we needed. So here I realized that I'm quite short on time. And I was not confident at all, even with the speed. What I'm doing now, I'm doing Whirlwind on the boss just to stack Stricken on it. There is no reason to start straight away Hammer of Ancients, because with Whirlwind, you stack Stricken faster, actually. Whirlwind itself, it's faster, and also you have the Dust Devils that also accumulate Stricken. And because it's a single target, it's easy to accumulate Stricken. So we'll do like around 1 minute of Whirlwind and close to 2 minutes. Like, we can see that it's almost 2 minutes on the bar, like visually approximately. We will take the shield, and then hopefully shield, it's almost double damage. It works very well as for the monk, because with shield we get our squirts. You can see here squirts, we have squirts. We get the squirts at 10 stacks guaranteed. And we start Hammer of Ancients. As you can see here, at this point, I'm not pleased at all how the damage goes. Like, I do a couple of rotations. We do it on fire here with Oculus. And you can see that it's not enough. I'm also always, Jesus, what I'm talking about. I'm quite gutted here, losing my hope slowly. I've had so many attempts like this, you can't even imagine. Even better than this as well. And as I realize here, that we are closing to 1 minute actually, and it's going faster now because of a streaker, but still I estimated that nothing happens. Like, it's not enough. And as you could see, we had that unexplored map there as well, and there is always also like a pylon spot. And what came to my mind, like, I gambled it and I said, like, screw it, let's discover it. Like, I will lose a couple of seconds moving up, just let's check it. Maybe it spawned before Kondi and we've never went there. And guess what, it spawned, and it was power. And here we go, we got it. I was very happy. And at some point here I will do the We'll do the, of course, the sunglasses. So let me take me off for a moment. Here, I just couldn't believe it. Like, finally, I was so happy. And also in this session, it came quite fast, actually. It was like my P for 10th key. So I just started for the evening. Usually I would do like 3-4 hours of pushing. And here you can see that I pop up the camera. It's a round camera, small camera. And here we go. We go with the glasses. We do a Woody here. Talk with my daughter happily. And I give her the sunglasses. So we stay cool. We stick to the tradition. And I will go to town now to showcase you the build. On the build itself, guys, I'm as usual, I'm planning to do a guide, even if it's the end of a season and most of you don't need it anymore. Probably, I think you're done with your season. Because it's HOTA, it's very small difference with regular HOTA that you don't get without season 27 power. So HOTA will still be alive in next season. Not so powerful, but will still be alive, so that guide will still be useful. So I will go on ahead and do the guide as well. It should come out like next days, where I will break down exactly how to play this build, how to build it, key aspects, key moments, how to maximize the value of it, and how to play it correctly. Down, closing, and here you see the build. The build itself, which again, I will cover in a separate video, but that's it. That's what I have. Quite good gear, actually. I spent a lot of maximizing this build because at this low Paragon, you have to compensate with perfect gear, basically, or very good gear and skill. Here is the build. Here I didn't showcase the skills, I guess. Stupid me, but it's standard skills, basically, for this build. I will cover them in next video, guide video. But I totally forgot about the skill. So the treble is down, guys. We've done 3 out of 4 150s that we have as target for this season. And what do we do when we get the treble? We go for quadruple. Next, in the remaining weeks, I will hardly push the wizard. That's the last one that is left. And probably there is a probability I'll do it on the stream as well. We shall see, but at least off stream and recording it, putting it on YouTube. So hopefully it's coming. Hopefully we'll get it. That's my last target for this season. And hopefully we get that quadruple down. That's the least build I have. So here I'm showing area damage as well. That's the least build I like. It will be a struggle because it's very hard to play a build that you don't enjoy, and I don't enjoy that one. But for the purpose of educating you to set goals and go for them, I will try to do it for you guys, for me and for you. We go for quadruple. But before we do it, you can have a look at NecroClear just to remember how we did the double. And see you soon with Barbarian Guide and then Wizard Clear, probably. Happy hunting, guys. We've done it. Rebel is home.